Before I ask Waja Mir Shoaib Mengal to come over, and he's going to read something about Shaheed Saba Dashtyari, whom you know that he was martyred last year. Yesterday was his first martyrdom anniversary. And Saba Dashtyari did a lot of things for Baloch society and Baloch movement. He was a professor at Balochistan University. He was teaching theology, and at the same time he did quite a lot of literary work, and he established his very good library in Karachi, in Malir. I'm sure if you go around, then you can find a lot of Balochi literature and literary work. Thank you very much. Waja Mir Shoaib Mengal is going to read something about Waja Saba, Shaheed Saba Dashtyari. Mir Shoaib Mengal, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, since the day our land has gone into the hands of barbaric occupiers, Baloch nation has lost many great sons, but there have been few deaths that made almost every one of us cry like a child. One of such tragic losses was when Ustad Saba Dashtyari Baloch was murdered. The legendary teacher of Balochistan was brutally killed exactly a year ago by the Pakistani army. Who was this legendary teacher that is considered a guru by many Baloch youth? Ustad Saba's ancestors basically belonged to Lasbela, eastern Balochistan, but they subsequently migrated to Dashtyar in western Balochistan and finally settled in historical Baloch city of Mai Kulachi or Karachi. It was the year of 1953. The lower middle class family of Muhammad Osman and the area of Maripur, where Ghulam Hussein opened his eyes, who was to turn into the respected Ustad Saba for Baloch nation in coming years. In his early days of life, Ustad Saba was raised in the company of famous Baloch writer, novelist and poetess Banal Dashtyari and the famous Baloch intellectual Saad Hashmi. Saba attained his earlier education from Liari and did his matriculation from Okahi Memon School. He did his intermediate from SM Commerce College in 1973. He graduated in 1976. Later, Mr. Dashtyari obtained master's degree in Islamic studies and philosophy. He started with his PhD in 1979, but got a job as lecturer in Balochistan University and preferred to help his nation through teaching profession instead of continuing further studies. From 1979 till his brutal murder in 2011, he remained a professor of theology at Balochistan University. He was fluent in many languages, including English, Persian, and Arabic. He started his literary work by writing poetry in Urdu and subsequently began writing in Balochi. He wrote his first poem on the death of famous Baloch singer Ustad Jaruk. In 1984, inspired and encouraged by famous Baloch writer Abdullah Jan Jamaldini, Ustad Saba completely abandoned writing in Urdu language and solely adopted Balochi language for his literary works. He started writing poetry and short fiction stories for Radio Balochistan. Ustad Saba himself was very much inspired by the personalities of Saad Hashmi and Abdullah Jan Jamaldini. He considered them his teachers and gurus. In 1983, Ustad became member of Saad Academy, a Balochi literary academy, and became its vice president in 1988. He also became the deputy editor of monthly magazine Balochi in 1988 and founded a literary organization, Chedad, in the same year. In 1994, his fiction work, Hona Hosham, was published. He was author of at least 24 books. He devoted his whole life for the promotion of Balochi language and culture because he believed that until and unless Baloch do not realize the importance of their culture, they could never surface as independent and civilized nation in real terms. Those taught theology, but he was a liberal and open-minded person who was not reluctant to discuss any topic that others considered taboo. One of his greatest achievements was laying down the foundations of a premier Balochi language academy, Syed Hashmi Library, in 1996 in Karachi. Syed Hashmi Library fully started functioning in 2002. It's not just a library, but a treasure for Baloch nation. It has hundreds and thousands of books on Balochi literature. It's the only place in the world where more than 95% of all the published magazines or pamphlets of Balochi language can be found. During the last days of his life, he was planning to form a Balochi Encyclopedia Committee and a research academy by the name of Balochiology Institute of Research. Professor Saba spent most of his salary on promotion of Balochi language and improvement of the library. He also used to pay the education fees of many Baloch students who couldn't afford to do so. His talent and intellect were not only limited to literary works, but he was also a great activist and a big supporter of independent Balochistan movement. After the murder of Baloch leader Nawab Akbar Khan Bukhti in 2006, Ustad Saba practically started participating in protests and activism for the legitimate rights of his people. He witnessed the extrajudicial killings of his own students, but he never trembled on his stance. He revolted against the tyranny and started leading marches and protests against Pakistani occupation of Balochistan. Not confined to this, he also made, with his teachings, a whole platoon of Baloch students who were armed with ideologies that stand firm as mountains and who would never retreat or surrender. He preached liberalism to Baloch youth for many decades. Due to Ustad Saba's enormous achievements and help for the Baloch movement, he was rightly titled Kandil-e-Baloch by Baloch National Defense Forces. The tyrant enemy of Baloch nation could never tolerate a Baloch who was a walking institution, university, and encyclopedia in himself. The enemy knew that this person was enriching the minds of Baloch youth with ideologies that will be driving force for the struggle against slavery for years. A struggle that can never be defeated with brutalities. Out of this fear, the brutal enemy killed our beloved Saba. Ustad, we miss you. We miss that humble person in his own classical attire who was not less than an angel. Ustad, we miss the way you smiled whenever you saw your students. We miss that warm welcome, Ustad. We miss the way you kissed your students whenever you met them, irrespective of whether you personally knew them or not. Ustad, we miss those chats we used to have in the cafeteria of Balochistan University, where you used to treat every one of us as your friends. We miss those discussions where we used to discuss everything. Dear Ustad, we miss those difficult Balochi words that you used, and we also miss those long definitions that you would tell us when we used to ask the meaning of those difficult words. Ustad, you are not an individual, but an institution. Ustad, we miss your teachings, but Ustad, let us tell you a good news, that your students are fighting the tyranny with full zeal and power. The uncountable brutalities, enforced disappearances, and murders couldn't tremble the cognizant students that you had equipped during your lifetime. Ustad, they have killed many of those who used to sit with you in the cafeteria, but they couldn't break them. The thousands that you had equipped with the ideologies are still fighting the enemies, and due to your earnest teachings, they are increasing in number with each day. Dear Ustad, our enemy has lost it at many fronts, and it is not far when your students will bring the enemy to the justice and prod them for the brutalities, including your heartbreaking murder. Ustad, you are unique and irreplaceable, but your teachings are always there with us, and with the strength of these teachings, we will defeat all the intruders and occupiers. Vati shahidani hona ke par sang makand, balochon bikand dushmana go jang makand, main vashnet ke rit ka gand chukanzira, main zah par chavatar greshage pulang makand. Thank you.
Thank you, Mir Shoaib. Just wanted to say something about Mir Shoaib. He is the representative of Baloch Student Organization, international, if I'm not wrong, international representative of Baloch Student Organization.